Seth Walter joins us from the New York Daily News. He is the New York Jets beat writer, and the live local late breaking is that Geno Smith is the new starting quarterback for the Jets this weekend against the Baltimore Ravens at home. Seth Walter, good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm good, Seth, and nice to have you on with a live local late breaking. And this news literally is just coming out, right?
Yeah, that's right. I mean, I want to be clear. I haven't confirmed it yet. You know, ESPN just reported that Geno Smith will indeed be the starting quarterback. Yesterday, Todd Bowles opened the door for that. After the game, after the Monday night loss to the Cardinals, Bowles said that Fitzpatrick will be the starter. And then yesterday, he backtracked, said he revisited the decision in his mind and had to talk to his staff about it.
Seth, you've been covering the Jets. That's your beat. Does this surprise you?
Does it surprise me? From yesterday, not so much, because I thought, well, you know, why open the door if you weren't gonna make that move? I wasn't sure that was the case, but I thought it was definitely possible. At a certain point, you gotta make a change, right? I mean, they're 1-5. Their season's either over or all but over. You know, maybe this is the last gasp move for them.
Is he the best choice, I guess, of the three, right? You look at Bryce Petty, you look at Christian Hackenberg, and then Geno Smith. I mean, which of those three give you the best chance to win games?
Oh, right now it's Geno Smith. I mean, I think that the thing is that you have to remember, Bryce Petty has been injured. He only recently returned to practice. Christian Hackenberg is not ready. I mean, I haven't seen him in practice. We don't see practice during the regular season, but I can tell. But from what I saw in training camp, I do not believe that he's ready, and I can't imagine he's made that much progress in the 6 weeks since then. So I think for now it's Geno Smith. Later in the year, could you see Bryce Petty and or Hackenberg play? I think definitely, especially if they continue to play poorly.
Seth, do you think, Seth Walter with us, we got live local late breaking here on Big Board Sports. Seth, beat writer, New York Jets, New York Daily News. Geno Smith named the starting quarterback against the Ravens. Now, I wonder if this will be a permanent thing for Geno Smith, or is this one of those, yeah, we'll give Geno a chance here, and if it doesn't work out with Geno, we'll either go back to Fitzpatrick, or maybe we will turn to Bryce Petty or Christian Hackenberg. I wonder how permanent Geno Smith will be, or will that depend largely, Seth, on how he plays?
I think it will depend how he plays. I mean, don't get me wrong, we haven't heard from Todd Bowles yet on his decision, but I can't imagine. I mean, what's the point, right? I mean, okay, you're trying to win games now, so you put him in there. But remember, Geno Smith, at the end of his contract, I would be surprised if he was a Jet next season. And I think it would make sense at some point if the Jets continue to lose, that you would try and see what you've got in one of your younger quarterbacks.
Yeah, because you don't expect Geno Smith, right, to be back next season.
No, I wouldn't think so. I mean, he's had a tumultuous 4 years with the Jets. He's, of course, you know, everything happened last year with Itan and Polly when Geno was punched in the face, lost the starting job. Clearly, this team doesn't think that highly of him because all throughout the offseason, they said, you know, Ryan Fitzpatrick would be the starting quarterback, you know, regardless of the fact that he wasn't under contract at the time. So, and they also have the two young guys in Bryce Petty, Christian Hackenberg. I just don't think it would make sense for Geno Smith or for the Jets to, keep this relationship going.
Hey, Seth, Zach Bye joining Roger in studio. I got to ask you this. Roger and I have been going back and forth for the past couple days on whether Todd Bowles should be fearful of his job. And I'm of the mindset of, hey, it's professional football. If you're expected to contend for the playoffs and you fall flat on your face, and this continues to if this continues to trend the way it has been, is Todd Bowles' seat going to warm up?
I don't think so. I don't think now. I don't think that Woody Johnson would want to make a move after just 2 years. This is a new regime that had more success than most people thought they were going to have last year. And you can look at it and say that might have been a function of their schedule. I don't think that Todd Bowles, it would make sense at this point for Todd Bowles to be on the hot seat. He probably deserves more of a shot. I mean, what? There's still a team in somewhat of a transition, with Fitzpatrick and the quarterback position has been unsettled, or it's at the very best had a journeyman. I think that Foles will be around.
Hey, Seth, what has surprised you the most when you look at this team? I mean, they can't run the ball. I thought the offensive line would be a little bit better. And really, defensively, the defensive line of the Jets highly touted in the preseason as possibly one of the best defensive lines in the NFL and haven't been able to stop anybody. I mean, we're outside of the quarterback play, you know, what are your major problems here with this Jets team that they sit there at 1-5?
The thing that surprises me is the defense. And I want to be clear too. I was very skeptical about this Jets team in the preseason. I picked them to go 6-10. I felt like their schedule from a year ago played a big role in them going 10-6, and they went from a super easy schedule to a very difficult one this year. The thing I was not expecting was the defense to be as bad as it is. That has been a surprise. I mean, even last game, when the run defense, which is the best part of this team, probably the most solid part of this team, failed them, that was shocking. And, of course, the pass defense has been nowhere near what you saw. Even with factoring in some decline for Revis, you figured they would be okay. But that obviously hasn't been that way at all.
Seth, I appreciate a few minutes busy. I know. Is the coach going to address this with the media here sometime today?
Yes, later today, I assume.
Gotcha. Seth Walter, New York Daily News on the Jets beat and the breaking news on Geno Smith moving in as the starting quarterback. Seth, thanks a lot, man. Appreciate a few minutes.
Thank you.
Seth Walter here on Big Board Sports.